If I take a walk outside, despite the fact it is only 11 a.m., the air is an impressive 37.8 degrees Celsius or 100 degrees Fahrenheit. And I measured the road asphalt indicating that it had a temperature of 68.3 degrees Celsius or 155 degrees Fahrenheit. Yikes, that's hot. Such is life in the Arizona desert. Yet, what if I were to tell you that despite this heat, Arizona used to have glaciers, with one particular glacier having only disappeared a mere 2,800 years ago. This glacier was not able to grow on Arizona's tallest peak, but rather adjacent to its second tallest point, largely due to its surrounding and favorable colder landscape than that of Flagstaff. But, if you were to dig deeper, the reason why these glaciers, which 20,000 years ago were able to cover 9.93 square miles or 25.73 square kilometers in eastern Arizona, was due to the rapid increase in elevation the formation of one of Arizona's youngest stratovolcanoes created. This is the story of Arizona's Mount Baldy volcano, which although today is long extinct, still towers to an impressive height of 11,421 feet or 3,481 meters. However, if we go back in time to just after Mount Baldy's last eruption 8 million years ago, this peak would have been the tallest point in all of Arizona, achieving a summit height of slightly more than 13,000 feet or 3,962 meters. To understand the origins of Mount Baldy, we need to first go back to 12 million years ago when magma started to intrude into the crust at a natural weak point related to a more than 1 billion year old subduction zone. Specifically, 1.7 billion years ago, a large convergent tectonic plate collision was ongoing across what is now New Mexico and eastern Arizona. Eventually, this subduction zone suddenly shifted southwards, leaving large amounts of hydrous mineral-rich oceanic crust in the upper mantle and lower crust. This lowered the temperature which rock could melt at, causing this region to act as a permanent weak spot in the crust known as the Jemez Lineament. This formed a number of geologically recent volcanic fields with fairly long lifespans, including what would become the White Mountains volcanic field. This volcanic field began erupting 12 million years ago, initially creating gas-rich, mildly explosive eruptions which formed cinder cones. These cinder cones created fairly long-traveling lava flows which were highly fluid, filling pre-existing valleys first and then forming basaltic lava plateaus. Intermittent volcanism continued shifting further northward over time until 9 million years ago Mount Baldy proper began to form. As magma finally found a dominant pathway to the surface, its gas content greatly increased, with this occurring to such a degree that it caused the magma to fragment into numerous particles of fine ash as it rose. As this ash was subsequently ejected as a jet into the air, a plume of ash rose, and falling material soon built around the vent to form a cone. These eruptions were more viscous than their prior counterparts, with eventual lava flows that erupted having a composition of trachy andesite. Thus, when lava flows did end up erupting from or near this continually growing cone, it formed thick 50 to 200 foot high masses which slowly advanced downslope at speeds of less than 1 mile per hour. These eruptions would frequently clog the vent feeding them, leading to powerful explosions which repeatedly generated pyroclastic flows that swept several miles downslope of the growing stratovolcano. Based on my interpretation of the geologic evidence, it seems that for the next 1 million years, a volcanic eruption occurred an average of once every 900 years, depositing an average of 33 million cubic meters of lava and ash with each eruption. By 8 million years ago, Mount Baldy reached a height of slightly more than 13,000 feet, at which point its summit stopped erupting. Highly infrequent eruptions would continue for the next 6 million years on its flanks, creating minor basaltic cinder cones. The millions of years of erosion by rain and wind, along with the four episodes of glaciation which followed, carved away much of Mount Baldy's original edifice, forming the numerous valleys and secondary peaks you see today.